16,000 deaths, 6,000 people injured and 2,500 people missing, and on top of that, the biggest nuclear disaster since Chernobyl. These are the horrible statistics of the 2011 earthquake and the following tsunami in Japan. On the 11th of March in 2011, an undersea megathrust earthquake off the northeastern coast of Japan occurred with a magnitude of 9.0. It was the most powerful earthquake ever recorded in Japan, and the fourth most powerful earthquake in the world since 1900. Good day, kings! In this video, we are presenting you with an overview over the tragic events of the 11th of March in 2011. If you like the video, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so that you can see future videos. The main earthquake occurred 373 kilometers or 232 miles northeast of Tokyo, and Sendai was the nearest major city, being just 130 kilometers or 81 miles from the epicenter. The undersea earthquake in Japan was actually so powerful that it shifted the earth on its axis by an estimated 10 to 25 centimeters or 4 to 25 inches, in the process increasing the earth's rotational speed by 1.8 microseconds per day. The earthquake was preceded by a number of large foreshocks, with hundreds of aftershocks reported. One of the first major foreshocks was a 7.2 magnitude event on the 9th of March, with another three in excess of 6.0 on the same day. Following the main earthquake on the 11th of March, a 7.4 aftershock was reported, succeeded by a 7.9 and a 7.7. Over 800 aftershocks of magnitude 4.5 or greater occurred in total, including one more than 2 years later, on the 26th of October in 2013, with a magnitude of 7.1. It is suggested that there is an 800 to 1100 year recurrence interval for large tsunami-genic earthquakes in this region. In 2001, it was reckoned that there was a high likelihood for a large tsunami hitting the Sendai Plain, as more than 1100 years had elapsed since the last one. In 2007, the probability was estimated as 99% within the next 30 years. The 6 minutes lasting earthquake triggered powerful tsunami waves that reached heights of up to 40.5 meters or 133 feet and traveled at a maximum speed of 700 kilometers per hour or 435 miles per hour and reached up to 10 kilometers or 6 miles inland. Residents of the hardest hit city, Sendai, were only warned 8 to 10 minutes before impact, and more than 100 evacuation sites were washed away. Delayed evacuations in response to the warnings had a number of causes. The tsunami height that had been predicted was much lower than the actual tsunami height. Also, there had been problems in issuing updates because of power failures and similar consequences from the massive earthquake. A report from 2015 indicated that over 228,000 people were still living away from their home in either temporary housing or due to permanent relocation. The tsunami inundated a total area of approximately 561 square kilometers or 217 square miles. Shortly after the earthquake, the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center in Hawaii issued tsunami watches and warnings for locations in the entire Pacific. In California and Oregon, up to 2.4 meters or 7.9 feet high tsunami waves hit some areas, damaging docks and harbors and causing over $10 million in damage. Waves of up to 1 meter or 3 feet and 3 inches hit Vancouver Island in Canada, prompting some evacuations. In the Philippines, waves up to half a meter or 1 feet and 8 inches high hit the country. It was reported that a 1.5 meter or 4.9 feet high wave completely submerged Midway Atoll's reef inlets, killing more than 110,000 nesting seabirds. The tsunami even broke off icebergs in Antarctica. As of April 2012, wreckage from the tsunami spread around the entire globe, including a Japanese soccer ball that was found in Alaska and a Japanese motorcycle that was found in Canada. Both the earthquake and the tsunami caused over 120,000 buildings to collapse, with a further 280,000 buildings being half collapsed and another 700,000 buildings being partially damaged. They also caused extensive and severe structural damage, including heavy damage to roads and railways, as well as fires in many areas, and even a dam collapse. Around 4.4 million households were left without electricity, and 1.5 million households were left without water. But it gets even worse. As if the earthquake and the tsunami weren't enough, another horrible incident took place. The tsunami caused level 7 meltdowns at 3 reactors in the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant complex. Level 7 is the most severe accident, also called major accident, on the International Nuclear Event Scale from the International Atomic Energy Agency. The loss of electrical power due to the earthquake halted cooling systems, causing heat to build up, which caused the generation of hydrogen gas. Without ventilation, gas accumulated within the reactor containment structures and exploded. The events led to 3 nuclear meltdowns, 3 hydrogen explosions, and the release of radioactive contamination. Also, the tsunami swept over the plant's seawall and flooded reactor buildings with seawater. In the days after the accident, radiation released to the atmosphere forced the government to declare an ever larger evacuation zone around the plant. Some 154,000 residents within a 20 km or 12 miles radius were evacuated. Large amounts of water contaminated with radioactive isotopes were released into the Pacific Ocean. An ongoing intensive cleanup program will take another 30 to 40 years. It was the most severe nuclear accident since the 1986 Chernobyl disaster and the only other disaster ever to receive the Level 7 classification. As a result, Germany announced that it will completely withdraw from the nuclear industry until the end of 2022. The World Bank's estimated economic cost of the events in 2011 was $235 billion, which makes this earthquake followed by a tsunami and a nuclear incident by far the most expensive natural disaster in human history. Thank you for watching our video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so that you can see future videos. What's the worst natural disaster or generally the worst incident that you remember? The current forest fires in California and Oregon are definitely also up there for us.